Hey everybody.
It's 2019, so it's the time that we embark on all of our crazy schemes about how we're going to get fit and eat healthy and save all the money and just become the perfect human being. So over the past few months, I have been actively trying to figure out ways to save money. Part of my issue is that I tend to forget how much I'm actually spending. That is really what I'd like to call unnecessary spending. And I mean, we all do this. It's nothing to be ashamed about. I mean, I am a fairly minimalist person, and I still spend money all the time on things that I don't need, and I don't even really want. I just get caught up in the moment, and I buy it, and I bring it home, and I'm like, cool, that was a rush. Now I have this thing that I don't want. I should probably get rid of it. And I just want to nip that in the bud. When I kind of actively decluttered and did the whole Con Marie thing that was all the rage a while ago, I was really good about getting rid of stuff. I've always been great about getting rid of stuff, but I'm still really bad about bringing stuff into the house. And it doesn't really make sense to bring stuff into the house just to declutter it. I don't want to continue to do that. It's not cost effective. It's not a good use of my time, and ultimately I want to get away from that. And kind of the YouTube gods just shone down on me, and I found, I believe her name's Hannah Louise Preston. If that is wrong, I apologize, but I'll put the name on the screen. I'll put her info down in the information box. And she did, in 2018, she did a no-buy year. The entire year, she stopped all of her unnecessary spending. And this is a trend that's kind of been going around a little bit, and a lot of people are hopping on the bandwagon for 2019, myself included. What it basically entails is, it's exactly what it sounds like. I will only buy things that I deem necessary. And that's really the only rule. Like, I've seen people do, like, detailed lists of what they're allowed to buy and what they're not allowed to buy. That just seems too complicated to me. I'm not gonna mess with that. It's all about self-discipline, and if I can't be self-disciplined in the moment enough to know what items are necessary versus what items are not necessary, then there's kind of no reason to have this challenge anyway. If I'm at a point where I am in a store and I'm holding a thing of deodorant in one hand and a scented candle in the other, and I can't determine between those two which is the necessary item, then there's probably more issues that I have that I need to address. So I'm not gonna, like, actually sit down and actively make lists, but, you know, the basic necessities, right? So I need food, I need to pay my bills, I need to have toiletries and basic cleaning supplies and things like that. I need litter for the cat, food for the cat. The stuff that I absolutely have to buy, I'm going to continue to buy. So it's not like I'm just going to stop all spending. But I'm going to stop spending on unnecessary items. And for that, mostly it's going to be books. Books are a thing I buy a lot of. I bring a lot of books into the house, and I already have just this huge collection of unread books that's going to take me years to get through, and I don't need to keep adding to that pile. And the same thing is true with video games, board games, pretty much any kind of entertainment. Entertainment is something that I've figured out ways to buy really reasonably. I feel like the amount of entertainment that I'm getting back from the amount of money I'm spending, it's a really good value, and so I can continually justify that. However, I have so much of it built up that's untouched. I have so many unplayed video games. I have so many unread books. It's not going to hurt me to go a year without accumulating more of that stuff. So I'm not going to buy any books. I'm going to cancel all of my subscriptions to, like, Audible and Humble Bundle and all of those things that just continually pile on more to the massive piles of stuff that I have to get through. I am going to allow myself to buy some unnecessary items. I'm going to clarify that right now. Experiences. So if I go to the movies, or if I go out to dinner with some friends, or there's some conventions and things that I already am planning on going to, I'm going to allow myself to spend the necessary money to go to that convention, including, you know, food, lodging, transportation, all of that. All of that is going to be money that is spent on experiences that I get immediate gratification back from, like, not just like the gratification of, oh, I have this new item, now I'm going to put it on my shelf and never use it. The gratification of, oh, I have this new experience that it's going to be something that I treasure forever. So I categorize that something different. It's just, you know, it's arbitrary rules that I make for myself. So experiences I'm allowed to purchase, and I'm allowed to purchase gifts for other people. So I'm not just going to be like a Scrooge and never buy birthday gifts or Christmas gifts or anything like that. I'm going to continue to buy gifts for other people. But other than that, it's pretty much gonna be like the necessities. Food items are gonna be kind of maybe my occasional splurge thing. Like, I know I don't actively need anything to drink but water. Like, water's the only real necessity when it comes to drinks, but I'm gonna buy other drinks. It's just gonna be a thing that I'm gonna do. Coffee for me is a necessity. So food is kind of that weird area, but I'm gonna try to not buy as much junk food. I'm gonna try to stop drinking as much soda and just kind of actively be better about that within this bigger project of just spending less money. I'm also gonna try to eat healthier. While I'm doing this, I'm gonna track my progress in two ways. I have my bullet journal here, which I just set up. And on one of my little notebooks inside it, I have a wish list. So this is going to be where anytime I think of something that's one of those non-necessary items, I'm going to put it on my wish list. And then at the end of the year, I'm going to be able to reference back to this and kind of see how many of those items stayed on my wish list. Because I feel like there's a lot of times you put something on your wish list and then a month or two later, you don't really want that item anymore. So this is gonna be kind of a way for me to track the things that I think I want in the moment and see if they're actually things that I still want at the end of the year. And then every month I'm going to also track all of my spending, and this is everything. This is utilities, rent, food, gas, all of the things that I need to buy. And that's just gonna allow me to have some kind of idea of how much I'm spending each month and how much I'm saving. Also, more so just to keep myself accountable than that I actually think that this is really entertaining content. I'm gonna do monthly check-ins, and it's just gonna be a quick, like, this is what I spent, this is what I wish I could have bought if I wasn't on a no-buy challenge, and just like general like thoughts of where I am in the process and if it's something that I think is worthwhile. This is not something that I think is horribly realistic, and I'm not sure how well I'm gonna stick to it. Even if I slip up, even if I end up buying something, I'm just like, that really wasn't necessary. I'm not gonna like just throw it all in the trash. I'm gonna keep trying. So that's kind of just where I am with all of that. It's been a very long, rambly video. I apologize. I didn't really have any set idea of how I was gonna approach this. It's just kind of something I wanted to try and document my process as I go through. It's weird to say that I'm excited about not spending money, but I genuinely am. And I think I'm most excited because there's so many things that I already own that I want to get to. There's so many books that I want to read. There's so many games that I want to play, and I already own them. But for some reason, I seem to never get to those things because I'm buying new things that I get to before I get to them. So just the ability to go through the backlog of everything I have is gonna be amazing. I'm so excited for that. But anyway, yeah, that's the video. I'm gonna say something now like, tell me what you think about the no-buy challenge. Is it absurd or is it the best idea ever? Leave a comment below. Subscribe, like, all of those things that I never say in my videos. Because I don't like doing any of that. And now I feel like I'm arbitrarily doing this because I don't know how to end videos without doing that stuff because that's how everybody else ends videos. And now I'm rambling more in any way. Hey, don't buy stuff. Well, buy stuff, but only stuff that you need. I'm just gonna stop.